So I worked for NASA for almost 30 years, and I just retired from NASA and started teaching, or started as a faculty member at a university in Florida in the United States. So my job for 30 years at NASA, the first 10 years I worked on the space shuttle, and I was testing it and troubleshooting when things were broken, keeping it flying. The next 7 years I worked on the International Space Station, helping to put together the communication systems on that and testing it, getting it ready for launch. Then since that time, for the last 12 years, I worked in a technology development lab, and I co-founded a laboratory known as the Kennedy Space Center Swamp Works. The Swamp Works is the lead organization in NASA for developing mining in space. So if you want to do mining or and also manufacturing in space, if you want to use the resources of space, then you need to start out by mining, extracting the resources from the environment, then you have to process, and then you can do manufacturing with those materials. It's really important that we start using resources in space, because launching is too expensive. If you launch water into space, the cost of putting an ounce of water in space is more than the cost of buying an ounce of gold. So we have a saying that an ounce of water in space is worth more than an ounce of gold. If you want water in space, you have to pay the price of gold to get it. And we need water in space. We use water for actually rocket propellant. When you use electrolysis to split the water into hydrogen and oxygen, that is your rocket propellant. And when you burn the fuel, the hydrogen and the oxygen in your rocket engine, it makes water again. So we need lots of rocket propellant if we want to do things in space. We also use water for radiation shielding. Here on the Earth, we're protected from radiation by the Earth's magnetic field and by the thick atmosphere of the Earth. But up in space, we don't have that, and so we want to put more radiation shielding around the spacecraft. Water is the best radiation shield. So there are some reasons why we want water in space. And fortunately, we know there are a lot of places where we can get water in space. The moon has water deposits at the North and South Pole. And there's enough water that if we turned it into rocket propellant, you could launch the space shuttle every day for 1,000 years. That's how much water is at the poles of the moon. Also, there are asteroids. And a lot of the asteroids are as much as 20% water by weight. And so if we can just capture these small asteroids, then we can get the water out. We think that this is the right approach to helping humanity get beyond just having one planet. If we start using the water in space, start manufacturing fuel, then the next step is to start extracting metal. We can make metal out of the lunar soil, or we can get metal out of asteroids. And once we can start making metal, then we can make spacecraft in space without launching them. We can also make solar cells so that we can get the energy from the sun and convert it to electricity. We have some ideas about how to make solar cells out of lunar soil. So these are some examples of how we want to use the resources in space. And I was involved in a test a few years ago where we were taking oxygen out of soil. Most rocks are 50% oxygen by weight. If you hold a rock in your hand, like this is a meteorite that came from North Africa, this is actually half oxygen by weight. Every rock, if you go walk on the sand, the sand is 50% oxygen. And so if you can just get the oxygen out of the rock, the studies tell us that we can cut the cost of doing missions to Mars by about one third, cut it down to a third of the cost, or make it even one-fifth of the cost just by getting the oxygen out of the rocks. So so we built some technology to get the oxygen out of rocks. And we took this technology up to a volcano in Hawaii. We had robots that were driving around digging up the soil, and they were dumping this volcanic ash into a chemical processor. The chemical processor was then using sunlight for energy to melt the volcanic ash, and it was using a chemical process to get oxygen out. And then we were liquefying the oxygen, making it very cold down to liquid state. And then we used the liquid oxygen to fire a rocket thruster. So the test went from volcanic dust to rocket thrust. And we called the test dust to thrust. So we did that in Hawaii a few years ago. And it was all very, very good. It all worked well. And we demonstrated that we can do these things in space. So we think that if we get started doing these things, then the next step is to start manufacturing in space. And then we can make the cost of spaceflight far less. And that will enable us to start doing more things in space. So that's what I'm working on. That's the area of technology that I've been developing, both at NASA and now as a faculty member at the university. My personal opinion is that this should be our number one goal in space. We should try to start industry on the moon and using asteroids that are close to the Earth. I think that's more important than going to Mars right now. That's my personal opinion. And I think that once we do this, once we develop these technologies on the moon, then it will make it far easier to go to Mars. Then we'll be able to afford doing missions to Mars. I wrote a paper a couple of years ago talking about how to start industry on the moon and how we can make it more advanced so that every year our technologies on the moon become more advanced until eventually we can have robots that build robots on the moon using entirely space resources, entirely resources that were obtained on the moon. And if we do this, then this industry that we put in space can double itself and then double itself again. And then we can send the robots to the main asteroid belt where the industry can grow very large. And once we get this very large industry on the moon, then it can start to build power generators in space that can beam the energy back down to the Earth. And so this is a way that we can start bringing resources back down to the Earth to improve life on the Earth. And by doing this, we can eventually solve all of the poverty problems that we have on the Earth. We can help the entire world get the benefits of a very high standard of living. And we can stop polluting the Earth, stop using energy sources that put pollution into the atmosphere. And so I wrote this paper and published it. And the White House, the Office of the President in the United States, actually read my paper. And they started contacting me and asking me questions about it. And so they started this new initiative that they're calling massless exploration, exploring space without launching any mass off of the Earth. So I'm very excited about that. I think that it holds the potential to revolutionize civilization here on the Earth so that we can take civilization to a much higher level. So that's an overview about what I'm doing. And Ajit, did you want me to answer questions?
Yes, my friend. Thank you very much. That was fantastic information. If you just give me 5 minutes to just translate the topics of what you say to Kurdish language, because what you say is something very strange we have never heard about, using the volcano ashes or using the water of the moon. Just give me a little break. I'm going to just tell the guys what you've done. دلی بو یکم زهره من او پیپری خوم نتو بحثی بخوم تقدیمی وایت هاوس یان بیت الابیض کدو موافقش انا سکدو لکولینوی لسه دکن بلم او شتانی که او بحثی که زور زور غریبه یک لوانه دلی او آوی که لسه مانگ هیا او آوی که ساوث بول و نورث بول بانگیزی لما تاویز بزانی ای مانگ نون دلی او آوی که هیا ایمه دتوانی بکاری بینو که سوتمنی همو روش کشتی آسمانی پی هل دین بو ماوی هزار سال بس سود لو برا آوی که لدبسری باشور هیا دتوانی ونگرین همو روش کشتی آسمانی بواسی او آوی یعنی آوی که دگورن بو وزدو سوتمنی شتی چی تری باز که دکتر فیلیپ که دلی لهاوی تجاربیان هیا لسر آش ولکانی آش خولمیشی گرکانی باشه چی او باسی که بردی چی پشاندن میتیورایت که دلی نظم نسبه که چیم سطح هشتای اکسیزین سطح پازده اکسیزین یعنی تصور که بارستای او برده سطح پازده اکسیزینه شتی چی زور غریبه یعنی تو لو برده اکسیزین در دینه دتوانن مشاکلی خوان پی حل کن فیلیپ آماجه بوی دا که ایمد دکری مثلا او سیستم او تفکیری او هی او طرحی او هیتی که موشک هل دینه آسمان بی او ایمه سوتمنی چی زور لگه خو من بینو کشتی چی آسمانی زبلاح دروس کنی و پاری چی گلی زور نخیر ایمه دتوانی کشتی چی آسمانی بچوک دروس کنی بچین سر مانگ بچین سر حسارکانی دی لوی سود لوزکانی وین در بگرین پرچه برده چی اونده او همو اکسیزینی تدابی که وات اوان تفکیریان لولای چی زور دور رویشتیا استاد حزه که اوکو بس اوکو پرسیار لای خود بنوسو اگر اوکو پرسیار دست چی بار او باسم کرد یعنی او دلی منو پاش او تکنولوژی که بکاری دی اینو تکنولوژی Okay, Doctor, my friend Philip, let's say, as you said me yesterday, don't say doctor. I said I've got to respect you, so I can't say Philip like that. My dear friend, now we are open the gate of questions. So if you're ready, we have questions for you, and we appreciate if you have your answers for it. بسیار کم به حذفی به سر دست بیاب کنید. زد سدال این لپیش شو لدوا و چون باشه ما مستعصو لپیش شو بالی دست بیاب کنید. کلای بدهی بیت برام بر کامل.
Hello, my name is Tara. I'm so happy to speak with you. But I'm speaking Kurdish.
I'll translate it for you. The question is she writing in Kurdish?
Saratay Druzbuni, Zawi Mank, Bahash Saad, Badawi Hig the Suranoa. Balam Jasiro, Suranoa, he was established to start at Emro, Tessihe, Larutani, Mstabashi, Krasoho, and Narasoho.
Philip, she said, as she read about that, the beginning of creation of the moon, she said that the rotation, the Dori Zebi, around the one rotation around Earth was taken only 8 hours. I don't know, is that, you know more than us, is that true? Is that happen in the beginning of the moon? It's rotating very quick around Earth?
I don't remember. I learned about that many years ago when I was in graduate school. But yes, the Earth, the moon is moving further away from the Earth. And the reason it moves further away from the Earth, do you want me to just say a little bit and then you can translate and then I'll say a little more? Haji?
Yes.
Okay, so the Earth is elongated by the moon. It's the, I will do this. Let's say this is the Earth, the Earth and the moon. And the moon pulls on the Earth, and it makes it elongated. It makes it longer like that. But the Earth is turning, and so the long part is turning away from the moon.
Yes.
So it's like this. It's turning, and so the long part is pulling. The gravity is pulling the moon, and it's pulling it, and it makes the moon go faster and faster around the Earth. And so as the moon goes faster, it gets farther and farther away.
Yeah.
And so this has been happening for a long time. And so the moon has been getting farther away. Now, it is ironic that when you go faster in orbit, it actually takes longer to go around, because although you are going faster, you're also farther out, and so the distance is more. So you're going faster and faster, but it takes longer and longer. So although the moon is going a lot faster now than it used to, it takes an entire month for it to go around the Earth now.
She asked, absolutely, there is no any connection between what happened to the moon and human. It's something natural happened to the moon, not artificial or the effect of human on the moon or something like that. It's naturally happened.
Oh, no. It's naturally. That is correct. It's a natural effect that the moon is getting farther from the Earth.
Thank you. She's asking about the Earth moonquakes. What about moonquakes?
So the moon does have moonquakes, like the Earth does as well. There are several types of moonquakes. There are moonquakes that happen deep inside the moon, down inside the mantle of the moon. Then there are other moonquakes that happen up in the crust of the moon, because the moon takes an entire month to turn around. So half the moon is in the sunlight for about 14 days, and then it's in pure darkness for 14 days. So it gets very hot, and then it gets very cold. And so when it is hot, it expands and creates a lot of stress in the surface of the moon. And then when it cools, it contracts. And so this expanding and contracting creates moonquakes.
او ودا كات كمان كاتيك او دو حفته روج بلاي جرمي زور برز بيتو سريع سيدا كملو كاتما بزنسي ولا اكيد كي روج لينا دا دو حفته زور سار دبي او سار دي جرمي ودا كا مانتيل ناخي مانغو لغا قشركي سري يعني تويك لكي ليك راب شو بستو بايك او هندك زار كويك يعني مون كويك يدروز دكا اوكي ماي دير فريند وي هاف انذر ستودنت
هاي ماي نيم ستابين بوتي أول سروي مانجني هو كارك بوش تقدر توا يا خو تاكو إست أول تنا سروي مانج دوزي وتوا.
She asking about the water on moon on the surface. She asked why there is no water on the surface of the moon. She said, is there any science for find water above on the surface of moon?
Yes. Okay. That is a very good question. And let me also say the previous questions were also very good questions. So the moon has no atmosphere. The moon is too small to have an atmosphere. There's not enough gravity to keep the air on the moon. So the moon is very pure vacuum. And at vacuum, water boils. So even at cold temperature, water in vacuum will boil. And so any water on the moon would instantly boil, and then the water vapor would go to space. It would escape the low gravity and go into space. But there is some water that is frozen as ice on the moon. And the reason it is still on the moon is because every once in a while, a comet will hit the moon. And when the...
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Just using the generator.
segment.
Just give us one break to using the generator, please. As I told you, something has happened to electricity power.
Okay. Do you want me to keep going?
You know the situation in Iraq. Nothing is moving perfectly.
Should I keep talking?
Yes, but they can't hear you very well, and they also, the photo and the image is lost, the video lost.
Oh, I see. I can still see you, though.
Yes. It's a webcam of the laptop.
I see.
This is a good chance to translate what you said right now about the atmosphere of the moon. Dr. Philip Dele, the very man, Berge Hawaii, Zor Zortan Chihe, and he started to even Hisabi Bonacret, where Nabuni Berge Hawaii, Wadakat, Kapastan Nabi, Kapastani Hawa Nabu Fizian, Au, water, Lassam Mang, Bashiwish, Nabi, the Zor Zor Zahmata, Wawe, Hashbeten, Yandabeta Sahol, Yamba Halam, Ladasio, the Rotten Bobo Shai Asman. Oh, I could work a mang, any Neptune, Berge Hawaii, Hasiku, Fasba. آویشیل بکار است رو که چکه اساسی بونی آویشیل ده هر شونه بیزگل پریگرمی چی که پستانی هوا یعنی ایر پریجر اگه ایر پریجر نبی زور زور زحمتا زور زور زحمتا اوکی پرابابلی وی کن یوز تایم سو اسک دی کوشن
اوکی لیت می آی واز گوینگ تو اکسپلین اباوت آیس اون دی مون دو
یا
سمتایمز ا کامت ویل هیت دی مون. Many of the craters that you see on the moon are from comets. And when a comet hits the moon, the comet vaporizes and it creates an atmosphere on the moon. And the atmosphere on the moon does not survive very long. Most of the atmosphere will escape into space, but about 1/10 of that atmosphere will freeze into the poles of the moon. And so over time, it has collected and created this water ice at the poles of the moon. And it is so cold that even though it's in vacuum, the water does not sublimate. It stays solid ice.
Great. Electricity coming back. Everything is okay now, my friend. Okay.
Okay,
Dr. Philippe. Okay. My friend, okay, thank you very much. Another question from now.
Hi, my name is Farhad, but I'm speaking Kurdish. I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital. I'm going to go to the hospital.
Thank you. Thank you very much. According to his question, he's briefly said, is there a chance to live on the moon after we heard all that, especially water, using the water?
Yes. We human beings need to have atmosphere, we need to have water, and we also need to have a food chain. We need to have other animals, other life. We cannot live without other life. But unfortunately, there is no liquid water or atmosphere on the moon, and there is no food chain. There is no other life on the moon. And so it is not a good place for humans to live. However, we have been inventing technologies that can do those things for us now. We can create an atmosphere, and we can mine the water on the moon and melt it. So we can create little bubbles where we have atmosphere and where we can live. But how do we get food on the moon? There's no other life on the moon. Well, again, because we have invented robotics, we have invented technologies, these robots can take the resources on the moon. They can take the soil and the sunlight and the ice, and we can make it into food. We can make everything that we need. So these robots can do the same things that plants and other life do here on the Earth in order to create an environment where humans can live. So it is now possible. We have not actually developed most of these technologies, but we know how to.
Thank you very much. Dr. Philip Dele, ببي يعني بواركاني ديكا ببي اشتاكاني ديكا هشتاكاني ترتوا ونابن بلا اما بيوستا بويكا وكو اوباسي كر ولو برقطع ملا اسناي اوين قلتنانا او اللي تيجي يشتم بلا دكري اما السود لهمو ريسورس كاني سر مانغور بقدين بتايبتي او تشكا او كي وين دري بيولا يعني او باسي دكا يعني H2O يعني او اتش صافو دتواني دهم بوارك بكاري بيني تاکید نوی چی کاره باعث ساده دو تاین اکسیژن و هیدروژن لیک زیاد کنن و با کاریم بینیم با هر دو بواریم با سوم بوار که ام پیوست ما پیدا بیله جانی خواهم. پرسیار؟ Question؟ Yes.
Hi, my name is Sundus. My question is about moon. We know moon round faster and faster, and the sun has magnetic field. Is sun factor of that gravity of the moon or not? Did the sun gravity of moon?
I'm sorry, I did not understand. You were talking very fast.
She said, is there an impact of solar activity? She asked, is there a probability that sun pulling the moon with its gravity, because the gravity of sun is, you know, it's very, very larger than the moon. So is there a chance to or probability that sun will gradually grabbing the moon for its surface in the future?
No, it's not really possible. It's not possible because the although the sun has much higher gravity than the Earth does, we are very, very far from the sun. And so the moon is actually very close to the Earth. And so even though the Earth has smaller gravity, because it is so much closer to the Earth, it feels a lot stronger for the moon. So I don't know a good way to say this. The gravity is, according to Newton's law of gravity, gravity gets weaker like 1/(distance)². And so because we're so far from the sun, it's actually a very weak gravity at this distance. My friend Ajit, does that explain it?
Yes, yes, thank you very much, yes. My friend, we've got to ask him quickly and answer also quickly because we have only probably 20 minutes before our friend Robert coming. So, by the speaking, Prisya. Yeah, another student here. بس أول بريشارة مهمة كي كلافيوس كريتر تشيبوت.
Hi, Dr. Phil. My name is Palin. I want to say thank you so much for this, about this information. And I'm studying in Fahim Megasology School. I have two questions for you, okay? Question number one is, has paramecium lived in the moon, or amoeba lived in the moon, or another? And question number two is, is there fire or volcanoes in the moon? If you say yes, so is it mean the presence of O2, oxygen?
Do you understand the question or I tried to?
I missed a couple of words. Could you help me understand? There were a few words I did not understand.
Okay.
Can I?
Okay, yeah.
Okay. He asked you about the moon. Is there which one was?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Has paramecium. Yeah, bacteria and some. Amoeba, paramecium, amoeba.
I see. Okay. Yes. We do not know of any life on the moon. We do not know of any bacteria or paramecium or any other life. As far as we can tell, the moon is too harsh of an environment for even microbial life.
Okay, and the second question, he changed it.
Okay,
yeah.
I have a question. How long does daylight last on the moon?
It is about 14 days, 14 and a half days. It's half of a month, because a month is how long the moon goes around the Earth, and the moon is always facing the same towards the Earth, and so therefore it takes a month for the different sides of the moon to face the sun as well.
And my last question is for you.
I don't think so, you have time.
Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you very much. We've got to, okay, yes, this one, this question is, I think it's a very nice one, because she asked me about something. Yeah. Introduce yourself.
I'm Fatima, and I am 14 years old. The South Pole Aitken Basin, which is the deepest crater on the solar system and the oldest on the moon, was the impact that caused this crater slow or fast moving? And why is the chemistry of the impact basin so different from the highlands?
Ah, very good question. Well, I do not know how fast the impact was on the moon, but in general, every impact on the moon has to go at least 2.7 kilometers per second, because that is the escape velocity of the moon. And so gravity always pulls everything in to go at least that fast when it hits the moon. Some impacts on the moon can be much faster than that, but that is the minimum. Every impact on the moon has to be at least 2.7 kilometers per second. So it's very, very fast. Now, why is the chemistry different? It's because the impact was so big and so deep that it dug all the way down into the mantle of the moon. So the moon is what we call a differentiated body. When it formed, it was so big and it got so hot that all the metal melted and went down to the center, and the rocks floated up to the surface. And the in-between part is the mantle. And so the impact that formed the South Pole Aitken Basin was so deep that it went all the way through the crust, all the way into the mantle, down into the rocks that have a lot of iron in them, down into rocks that are called olivine.
Thank you very much.
Hi, I am Anas. I am in grade 10. I have two questions about Mars. Yeah, okay. What are the factors for having water on the Mars? Is the possibility to have the same factors that led to have water on Mars again?
Mars used to have a much thicker atmosphere than it does now. Over a long amount of time, much of the atmosphere has escaped into space because Mars does not have enough gravity to keep it as well as the Earth does. So the atmosphere has become very thin on Mars. The density of the atmosphere is only 1% of the density of the atmosphere on the Earth. And therefore, liquid water is not possible on Mars at the present time. Liquid water would boil away into vapor almost immediately. So it's possible that we do know for sure that the atmosphere was thicker in the past on Mars. And so it was possible that in the past there was liquid water on the surface. But there's still a lot that we need to learn about Mars. We still don't know for sure if Mars had an ocean at one time. We don't know if the water on the surface of Mars lasted for a long time or if it only lasted for a brief time. We don't know.
For future crashing with another moon or planets, I don't know if you.
I'm sure, Dr. Phillips. She said about moon. If moon get far away for three centimeters, suddenly, or gradually. Gradually, is that leave an impact on Earth? For example, the question is suddenly or quickly. Does that leave impact on Earth?
If the moon suddenly moved three centimeters?
Yeah, for example.
Well, the moon moves about that far every year. It moves a couple of centimeters every year farther away from the Earth. If it happened suddenly, I don't think it would cause a big effect. I think that gradually, over a long, long time, the moon moving away from the Earth will have an effect on the moon, on the Earth. It changes the tides here on the Earth. The month is getting longer as the moon moves farther away. And so the tides on the Earth will slow down and will change. Also, the gravity of the moon is making the rotation of the Earth slow down. So days on the Earth are getting longer. And so those are long-term effects, though, many, many millions of years for those to have much effect. I don't think there would be a very immediate effect.
Last question. We have only 9 minutes, probably.
Hi, my name is Sabin. Sometimes the moon gets too close to the Earth, to the point that you feel it is gonna fall off the Earth. What's the reason behind that, and what are the consequences of that?
I'm sorry. Could you say one more time, please? I think that is an optical illusion. I think when the moon is close to the horizon, sometimes it looks larger, but in reality, the moon is always at the same distance from the Earth and only very, very slowly getting farther away from the Earth. It's an imperceptible amount of change. But because of the optical illusion, when it is close to the horizon, low to the ground, looks like it's low to the ground, the moon sometimes looks a lot bigger. And I think it's because the way the atmosphere, sometimes the moon will look squashed because of the atmosphere refracting the light. But I think it's mostly just an illusion because our minds will interpret the way we see it when it is close to the ground.
My friend, we have a call from Robert Zubrin right now, and I'm going to answer the call. We've got to wait a little bit, Dr. Robert. Dr. Phil, thank you very much. That was a great opportunity for us, and I'm sure the guys here and every people standing here. How did you see the questions of the students? How did you find that?
Those were wonderful questions. I can see they have spent a lot of time thinking about space and learning about gravity and about the moon. So thank you for the wonderful questions.
Thank you very much. Please give a big clap for... Thank you very much, Doctor.
It was my pleasure, that. Friend.
Thank you very much.
I hope we can do this again someday.
We try our best to do that again. Thank you very, very much. Thank you.
All right.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
My point is that if you want to do it, you can do it. Everyone who is involved in the space program, everyone who became a well-known scientist in any field, an inventor, or any of these things that you might want to do, at one point was in your position of just being a student in school, and thinking about it as a dream. So there it is. And life is what you make of it. Now, I am, the reason why I really like being involved in the space exploration, and well, in particular, in the development of technology for space exploration, which is what I do, is because I think this is the most important thing that is going on. I think that when people 500 years from now, look back at this time, this is what they will consider important. Now, I know this may be difficult because in Kurdistan right now, you are involved in a life and death struggle with an immediate evil force, and you have to take care of what is going on now. But nevertheless, the fight today so that our children can be scientists and their children can be artists. That's what we do. And I think that our time will be remembered because this is when we first set sail for other worlds. You know, human beings, you think of humans as native to the earth, but really human beings are only native to a small part of the earth, which is to say Kenya. That is where the first humans were, in the Kenyan Rift Valley. And we're actually adapted for that environment. We are actually tropical animals. That's why we have these long, thin arms with no fur on them. We only became a global species by developing technologies that allowed us to live in new places. I live in Colorado, where the winters are very cold, but otherwise it's quite a pleasant place to live. But no human without a certain amount of technology could live here. No human could survive a single winter night here without fire, without clothing, without houses. These are technologies, these are things that people invented that allowed them to become a global species and live all over the earth. Well, similarly, right now, there are other planets, and we do not yet have the technologies that could allow us to live there. We're close to developing them. But when we do develop those technologies, humans will go from a global species to an interplanetary species, and someday an interstellar species, with the universe open to us. And imagine how limited the human experience would be today if we had just stayed in the Kenyan Rift Valley, a few tribes living there. Instead, we are all over the globe, hundreds of nations, different cultures, different literatures. Well, if we go into space, if we establish the first human foothold on Mars in our time, then 500 years from now, there will be humans living on hundreds of planets orbiting stars in this region of the galaxy, with a much vaster human civilization and experience than anything that we can imagine today. And Mars is the first step, in my view, because Mars is the closest planet that has on it all the resources needed to support life and therefore technological civilization. So the moon is closer, obviously, but the moon doesn't have a significant amount of water. It doesn't have carbon. It doesn't have nitrogen. These are fundamental to life. Mars is a 24-hour day, very similar to the Earth. The moon is 2 weeks of light, 2 weeks of dark. Mars has had a complex geological history necessary for creating mineral ore. So Mars is a place we could settle. If we were to compare the current age of exploration to age of exploration that Europeans began in a big way about 500 years ago, the time of Columbus and Magellan and so on, Mars compares to the moon as North America compared to Greenland. You know, Europeans made it to Greenland first. Greenland's closer to Europe. But they couldn't develop a civilization there. It was too poor an environment. A few settlements, yes, but not civilization. So Mars is the grand prize of this first act of the new space age. Right. And that's why I think we should set our sights on Mars. With that, I'll take questions.
Doctor, thank you very much. So if you just give me a little break to translate that the topics of what you said about the important informations for the student. Just give me 2 or 3 minutes, please.
All right, sounds good.
Okay. طبعا دكتور باسي ويكت كدلي مان جاوازي شي كثير زوري لقلها ساري مريق طبعا مو بداياتي باسي جياني خويت بوتي من بين صالي هو زور حزن لبوالي فلك ناسي بوز بوتي او كاتي يشي تي سوبيتي او انا هبو امن كاتي خويت لبس اهتمام بعلم الفلك داس كنا ترسام ليكيتي سوفيتي د ترسات كو از دي يي بولا غير امريكاي لو كانت فهم د ترسام لو او ترسوي كده بس منو عمل فلك اهتمام بيبدا يعني لو خوش شنو بو كريم ما زو سيدة طبعا هي كم زار هيك لا ترسو بسي علمك بخيني شو بجمني شي هي لو لا شي انت بهر حال دكتور دلي
مريخ جورتين دياريا بو مروف دبروي مان جاوالي شي تازوري مان برغا هواينيا دو حفته شو دو حفته روجا نازان او مشتاني دكتور فيليب باسيكر بلام مريخ مارس زور چانسی زیادتر لوی مروف بیدوزی تو دره لخلالی 500 سالی ده هاتو اگر دنیا ما وقتی دنیا دیه نسوب کاملی دره 500 سالی دی تندان شهرستانی لحسارکانی دی که مروف یعنی بلین مروف دی گاتی مروف ده پانه شهرستانی دی که اصلا حساری دی که دوست که نه تنها دره سولار سیستم سیستمی خور بلکل دره سیستمی خور یعنی من تصوری وان 500 سالی دی مروف هنگاو یک زار زور گوره تر دنیل روی که استایه چه و با تصور یوان تکنولوژی استل بدایتی تی و زور خیره تطور دکا اوکی اور دیو گیس دکتر روبرت thank you very very much for this information and about your life in the beginning of the astronomy so we open the door gate of questions are you ready
yes
thank you Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name is Don. Before my questions, I want to thank you that you gave your time to sharing information, and I want to thank you. I really appreciate it, and it's an honor for us to talk to such a smart scientist in space explorations. And my question is that I know that you have a Mars Society and you have project to send humans to live on Mars. And I want to know, have you located the location that a human could live on Mars? And what's the time for that journey? And do you think that human is ready for a such journey on Mars? Thank you.
Dr. Robert?
Okay. Well, these are several good questions there. There's a wide variety of places on Mars that we might go. I would tend to go towards the equator because Mars is a cold planet, and so we'd want to go to the warmest part of it. And in particular, we would not want to go to live at the poles. We could go to visit
because at the poles on Mars, half the year it's dark and you have no light at all. And the Martian year is twice as long as the Earth year, so that would not be good. The poles are interesting in that there's water ice there. But I would go to tropical or at most mid latitudes, and I'd go to low altitude. You want to translate that part, and I'll take another section?
Okay. Equatorial, Mars equatorial regions are better than the poles.
Right. Now, excuse me, he had more questions than just that,
yes.
So I'm going to try to answer at least a few more of them.
Sure.
I think that if there was a serious decision to do it, we could have humans on Mars in 10 years. It doesn't take years, 10 years to travel to Mars. It would take about 6 months to travel to Mars. But it would take 10 years to develop the technology, the rockets, the spacecraft, and so forth. And okay. So now I'll take another question.
Okay. Thank you very much. So from the 10 years, will things get very developed in the next 10 years?
Yeah, well, they can.
Great.
Look, it took us 10 years from Kennedy's speech to landing on the moon. Actually, even though Mars is much further, our technology today is much more advanced. And so think it could be, we could be there in 10 years if we decided to do it. Now, right now, there isn't a decision to do it, but it could be done. There's also a private company called SpaceX, which is developing technology on its own that could get people to Mars.
Great. Great. Please. Do you have another question?
Hi, doctor. I'm Faris. I hope I come here and give my book. She will correct it.
My friend asked you about the color of Mars. He said, why Mars is reddish like that? And the gravity of Mars. It's the difference between Mars and Moon, Earth, from the gravity.
Okay. Mars is red because of rust. That is iron oxide. When iron combines with oxygen, it forms rust, like you see rusty metal. That's Mars's soil is very rich in iron, and so it is red. That's the first thing. And the gravity of Mars is about one-third that of the Earth. So, for instance, if you weighed 60 kilograms on Earth, you would weigh 20 kilograms on Mars.
Great. So you don't have to lose your weight. You want to lose your weight, you got to go to Mars. It's going to be better for you. Thank you, doctor. Thank you very much. Another question, please.
Hello, Dr. Robert. My name is Mohammed, and here's my question. Can we increase the amount of oxygen on Mars and help?
Okay. Mars today, its atmosphere is carbon dioxide. Initially, people who go to Mars will need to live inside of their spacecraft that they land on Mars. But it is possible that someday humans could make Mars to be a planet much more like the Earth. That is called terraforming, they call it. And the way we would do it is first we would warm the planet by putting artificial greenhouse gases in its atmosphere, and then like fluorocarbons. And then as the planet warms, its current atmosphere, which is CO2, will thicken because CO2 when is sponged into the soil, and when it is warmed, it comes out. And then once that happens, and also a lot of the water that is frozen in the soil as permafrost will melt, and you'll get liquid water and rain, and then we can spread plants around the planet. and the plants turn carbon dioxide into oxygen. And so Mars is red today, but someday it will be green.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Robert. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Hindi, and I have a question that they said that Phobos is one of the moons of the Mars, and it goes so fast around it. Why? And they said that if it goes so fast like that, it will crash the Mars and make it like a...
Doctor, that's an advanced question. She said, as we know, the Phobos is getting closer to Mars, and you know there's a chance to an impact between Mars and Phobos to the surface of Mars. She said, is that good that if you build a colonizing Mars and there is a threat on Mars, or this is happening after a very long time from now, the impact between Phobos and the surface of Mars?
It will take a long time. It will be billions of years from now.
Billion of years. Yeah, milyaran sal idi orada da. Balam akib kedole. Kaman dolen de ingizik de bitu obat kutin haya. As bavez da yom tin tua. Abole. Abole. Aalan afu. Aba sirra o hali. Abo. Aayna.
Hello, my name is Hannah.
Hannah asks you, is there four seasons on Mars, Dr. Robert?
Yes, there are. Mars, just like the Earth, has an axis and it rotates around and it's tilted about as much as the Earth's axis is, so that as Mars goes around the Sun, it has four seasons. It's just that each season is twice as long as the Earth season. In other words, the Martian year is actually 23 of our months long, just a little bit short of two of our years. And so each of its seasons, instead of lasting 3 months, lasts six.
Dr. Robert DeLay. طبعاً بتزو ساعة تقريباً ونيا مريخ بدوري خوالة دا سورتون والزخان هي فلان بوران كاريخان نيو إيما بارا مغاري وشانا درزي حرارة فرق لكا تيمبريتشر وبلام أنواع زوية نيا ليا وكش خوايا كدوية حتما دس الزوية دوية نيا بويا بلا اتشوع الورزكة هي وكو معنى علمي بلام بلا معنى لعيني كش ناسي تنها تسل ديار ديك نبي دريش بونو كم دنوية كاريخة يتسيكيني بس يكتك او يكتب زي غير سريع عفوا او ده دو صار رحنا بيت الزهر على الفيسبوك لام الحكومه هي المفروضه تقديم السلامه في كذا دو صار كما عاشوا مع زرق تقديم عدد سبب تقديم مريض ما شاء الله ما شاء الله سابو بيستا بس ما زرق يعني سيسا زرق على كل انا سينافسي اسد دكتور روبرت يا هاف انذر كويشن بليز
Hello, my name is Siad. Siad is from Aweil. I'm very happy. I'm glad to see you here. We are going to be talking about the Mars.
Doctor, this is very. Thank you very much. Very, very, very nice question. She asked about the magnetic or magnetic field on Mars. So is Mars have its gravity, own gravity, or it's different than Earth? Magnetic fields, she asked about that.
Okay, well, Mars has gravity, as I said, one-third that of Earth. It does not have a global magnetic field on Mars. So a compass that tells you which way is north would not work on Mars.
South or north? شته که نبینید چون مریخ مغناطیس که پارچه پارچه یعنی هر شوین هه بعد که این مغناطیس زور به ازا لحن یه شوینی زور لوازا بلا ما که زوینیه مثلا او با کرو او با شوینیه قبل ما لوه به اتجاه کنی که با غلط نشان داد. Thank you, Dr. Robert. Question? Yes. دینو. کنی زوره کنی من باشو.
Hello, doctor. My name is Sira, and I wonder, like, plate movements exist on Mars, on Earth, like continents are moving. So I wonder, is there plate movements exist on Mars and like other planets? Thank you.
Doctor, do you understand the question?
I couldn't hear it. Could you repeat it?
The plate movements, like the continents are moving, it exists on Earth. Like, is that also on Mars and the other planets?
Yeah, she means the tectonic activity on Mars.
Is there a continental drift?
Yes. She's asking about this. Yes.
No, there isn't, as a matter of fact. The Earth has what is called plate tectonics, which makes the continents move. Mars does not have plate tectonics. And this is actually pretty important. This is the reason why Mars's atmosphere is so thin. You see, on Earth, when it rains, the water comes down and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is dissolved into the water, or some of it is, and the water then goes into the ground and the carbon dioxide reacts with rocks and forms carbonates. But it's not lost because the plate tectonics of the Earth rotate all the material through the heat of the depths of the Earth, and those carbonates are broken down and the carbon dioxide is released again. On Mars, the early Mars, when Mars was young, had a much bigger atmosphere and it had liquid water. That's why there are dry riverbeds on Mars and dry lakes and even a dried up ocean. But because it doesn't have plate tectonics, when the carbon dioxide got stuck in the ground, it stayed there, or a lot of it did. And then that caused the planet to cool down and all the water froze. If we go to Mars and we warm the planet, we can drive much of the carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere, thicken the atmosphere, and make Mars warm and habitable again.
Thank you, Doctor. Dr. Robert, okay, doctor. Another question? I think we'll be sure, but I'm sure.
Hello, my name is Freya. My question is my question is, does the soil on Mars contain the ingredients needed to grow plants?
Doctor, do you understand the question?
Say it louder. I couldn't hear it.
She asked a question, and I know what it is. She said, "Is that the contents of soil of Mars supporting life?" Doctor, she said, is the soil of Mars supporting growing plants or something like that in the future?
Could we grow plants in the soil of Mars? Is that the question?
Yes, yes.
We can. Some of the soil, before you grew plants in it, you'd have to wet it with liquid water to make certain compounds that are in it that would not be good for plants to break down and go away. Others, Martian soil could be used as is. People have done experiments in which they grow plants in simulated Martian soil. And in fact, this is something that perhaps an experiment that you could do. You can look in books of the composition of Martian soil and try to create some soil that is like it and grow some plants.
خاشی مریخ دکتری حتی اگر این کانیت بی لمالوا تکلیم تکاتی خاشی مریخ دیاره بلاو کرده ولی مثلا اگر این کانه بی آوت از زیبا شان کردیه خاکی چیو چی مریخ شان دوست کردیا نکش شو هلاک بس خاکه یا جیال روشتانه و نمی شین بوه یعنی نفسی تکاتی خاشی مریخ
But you have to grow the plant if you're on Mars, you have to grow it in a heated greenhouse.
Yes. That's right. The Khani Shushay greenhouse, the Khani Shushay de Vidani, a gentleman, but atmosphere of Kuzerinia, Boy Demri, but I'm told a greenhouse to the Khani Shushay again. Zorba assigned the Khachi Marie, Rob Shin David, the Jet. Thank you, doctor. Question?
Another question, please.
Dr. Robert, it's okay for you? You're not busy or something like that? Can you continue with you?
Speak loud. The microphone is not as loud as it was.
Oh, doctor, I said it's okay for you. You're not so busy. Can you continue?
Yes, I'd be happy to continue.
Thank you very much. Okay, we have another question.
Hello, doctor. I'm
Sihwan.
I'm my question is there a day and night on the Mars? If yes, is the time like Earth or is it different?
Was the question, do we have day and night on Mars like Earth?
Yeah, she said it's similar with Earth or it's different.
Well, yes. In fact, the Martian day, it turns in about 23 hours, 40 minutes. So there's a day and night, and they're just a tiny bit longer than the Earth day and night.
Thank you. I'm in Tsharek Bodiktori. Doctor, I'll ask you a question. It's from me now. But I'm saying in Kurdish before I translate it to English to you. Tsharek Dale, Hadek Lamayan Dalin Amaba Mushachis, Nawari, Kumbale Zarila, Marik Dame Boy, Greenhouse Effect, Druskenu, Hibasi Harari, Katismini Gemitsi, Kadalimakulizi, Global Warming, Bawase Zarbay Nawari, the Marik. As I was sharing the example, Dr. Robert, I heard several years ago that there is an idea to bombarding Mars or nuking Mars by nuclear.
Hold the microphone up closer.
Okay.
It's hard to hear.
It's okay now?
Yes, now.
Sorry. There is an idea I heard several years before now. They said we can nuke Mars, nuclear weapons, bombarding Mars to make the global warming, you know. Is that a good idea to let the water evaporating from the land to this atmosphere? Is that a good way to let the changing climate change on Mars faster, sooner, faster and faster?
I've read that paper, but I don't think it would work. You could. If you bombed the south pole of Mars, you could put a lot more CO2 in the atmosphere because there's frozen CO2 there, but it wouldn't last. It would go bad. I think if we're going to warm Mars, the way we need to warm Mars is by putting greenhouse gases in Mars's atmosphere. That is, you've probably heard about global warming and the greenhouse effect.
Yes.
Yes. That is warming the Earth really only a tiny bit, but it is warming it. Well, there are gases that we could make that are very strong greenhouse gases that really would do a good job of warming up the planet. Now, of course, we don't want to do that on Earth, but on Mars we do. And so if we set up factories on Mars that manufactured these kinds of gases, they're called fluorocarbon gases, and release them to the atmosphere on purpose, we could warm the planet a lot.
دلیل نکرده برای اگر تو بمبی نووی به او کلیه هم که در سری باشوری مریخ دن در ساوف پولی مریخ دن و فرکی بتاوی نو بتا هلوم بسا آسمان بلام دلیل دعای ماوی اگر برای پنگی هوای اصلا زور ناس که مریخ زاری چطور او بفرو او در هلوم که در نشید و دیستان دو بیتو بفر بلام دکتر روبرت دلیل دکلیه مثلا امام مجموعه افکار هی لعنه نردنی چند کارگیه که روس کتین سن کاری که بس غازی میفان و آمونیا و یا او غازانی که گلوبال وارمینگ دروز دکا سی او تو مثلا سی او تو زورا گاز کانی گرم کاری دیگه لبرگ هوای مریخ زیاد کا یعنی معمل بس دو کلی فرادات آسمان غازی دروز کا دلی او باشترین فکره بلا امن بیستیتم که رنگ هزار سالی بوده بیدن ایجا حتمی مریخ با دو کل با چشتی پیز با هوای پیز تا لگه می برز بیتو باران وشد دست بیاره او فکریه یکا دکتر رابرت Can we continue or
I can continue
Okay We have question بیشتر تو تقریبا پرسیار با بین نوع ایر Thank you, Doctor. We appreciate that.
Hello, Doctor. My name is Thomas. What's the effect that created in the gravity in the Mars? What's the effect in the that created in the gravity?
Hold the microphone close and speak loud.
What is the effect that created in the gravity in the Mars?
He said, what is the reason that made the gravity or the force that made gravity on Mars? What is it? It's like Earth?
The reason why Mars's gravity is less than Earth is because Mars is smaller. Mars is about half the size of the Earth. That is, its diameter is half as big. And so it has less mass, and so it doesn't pull as strong with its gravity.
Great. Great. You
have
another question?
Yes. I
have a question.
But
do you want to go back to the sorry, question. Another question, please, we have?
So, by the way, just want to add something.
Yeah.
Because Mars's gravity is one third as much as Earth.
Yeah.
If you could jump 1 meter high on Earth, you could jump 3 meters high on Mars.
Yes. Yani agar tu ayna sazi yek matir bazda, sazi mari se matir bazda dey.
My name is Don. I have another question. What is the biological effect is, or the biological changes that happen to human's body if they live on Mars?
Oh, okay, thank you. Dr. Robert?
Okay, well, that is an interesting question. And no one knows the answer for sure. When humans go into Earth orbit where there is no gravity at all, if they don't exercise a lot, they become weaker because they don't get the exercise that you get by walking around on Earth and holding up your weight. on Mars is one-third gravity, and so this effect would not be as extreme. But if you wanted to retain the amount of muscles and strength that you have now, you'd want to make sure you do extra exercise while you're on Mars. And if you did that, as I said, you would be capable of doing amazing things, because, for example, if you could jump 1 meter on Earth, you could jump 3 meters high on Mars. Now, what would happen to children born on Mars? Unless they sized and so forth, they would not grow to be as strong as Earth people. But if they did, they would. And because the basic human heredity would stay the same. And but if they ever went back to Earth, they would find it unpleasant. They would want to know why anyone would want to live on such a high gravity planet.
زورجوانا دلیل نسماریخ اگم شرط روز بکه آمون دلانه بیکنه دایی دبن زور خراب لیراده نگه وزاکه تا چن جیلی یا چن نوه یک اینجا بلا مگر او نوه یک لیره حد دسته کشی مریخ بینی و سر زمین آقا نمیشی لبرای هیچ ششکنی زوی هنده زورا از های about she said why NASA try to leave on Mars. Do they know that there's something bad will happen to Earth, or the end of the world is close, or something like that, or it happened in the future? So that's why NASA thinking about rescue or take mass from Earth to the moon, to new civilization, to the Mars. Sorry.
Well, there are some people who think that way, who say the reason why we should go to other planets is because, as we say in English, you should not put all your eggs in one basket. But that's not my reason. I don't think the reason to go to Mars is to escape the Earth. I think the reason to go to Mars is to create something new. I think that it's kind of like having children, okay? You don't have children to try to live forever. You have children to create something new. And in a way, the human settlements on Mars will be like a child of the civilization of the Earth. And I hope that we have many children.
Yeah.
Doctor, thank you, and we have one question.
Hi, Dr. Robert. My name is Phil. I have a question for you. We know in the Mars is a road. But I have a question here. The density rock in the Mars is greater or lesser than the Earth? Just I have a question.
Thank you.
Could you repeat it?
He asked about the density of rocks on Mars. Is it similar like Earth or no? It's different.
The density of rocks?
Yes.
Is similar to Earth. We have discovered quite a few kinds of rocks on Mars that are the same as rocks on Earth. But I'm sure we will also discover many that are different. But the density of rocks is comparable.
Doctor, I have a question.
I heard about the Spirit or Opportunity rover. In one of their data said mentioned that the temperature in the regions near the equator are reaching to 32 Celsius. Is that right?
It could be. That's actually new to me. I knew that temperatures had sometimes reached 20 Celsius.
Yes, yes.
It could be that on a particularly hot day, it could reach 30 Celsius. It's possible.
Yes, especially in the summer. That they indicate the source, or it was from NASA, said that the temperature was in the middle of the summer. So that reach it to 30 to 32 Celsius.
Right, but only in the middle of the day.
Yeah.
At night it gets very cold. I understand that Kurdistan is mountains.
Yeah.
And so you know that in mountains it can, even in winter, it could sometimes get warm in the daytime, but
yes,
get very cold at night.
Yes, sure.
Okay. Yeah, Colorado here is also mountains. We have the same kind of thing.
من دي پرسيده. Thank you, doctor. دي پرسي هندك تقارير هيدري بلي جميل لما ليف دقات سيتا سيبو بريسري يعني جرم طاو وكو تقريبا تصوبك ممكن استايجي او او در احتمال او قديم دراساتي بيشتر ده 20 درجه مئوي اكيد 20 درجه ده فايكين لا صالح حفتا وشوش كوريجن.
And by the way, I should add that the reason why if you have a big temperature change between day and night, if you are on a mountain, is because there's less air above you. The air above you is a blanket. It keeps in warmth. And if you're higher up, there's less of it, and so you don't have as thick a blanket. And Mars has very thin air, so it has a very thin blanket.
Thank you very much. Dr. Robert Dele, ومعلوماتش فتكش يستا بالفعل خير مواد دلي لبرتي ناو تكاني شاقاري مثلا زور ساعدة لبروي او ناو سانا برزت وتسند روش برزي برز بيا ونيا برجي هوا تاني تلو كم تبريتها سطحي مريخ وكو اوه تولى ستياشي زور برز بيوا بويا هوا لبي كمو بلي قرمي زور دادا بزي لبروي برجي هوا وكو سقفي قوائدة فاريزي اوه دلي. Another question, please. Yeah.
Hello, I'm Kusar. Has the Mars any effects on the Earth now? If suddenly Mars destroyed, is there any effect on the Earth now?
Could you repeat that question?
Yeah, he said if Mars, for example, destroyed or get far away from Earth, get out from its orbit and go to the deep of the space, for example. Is that left an impact on Earth?
Well, there wouldn't be much of an impact on Earth unless Mars came and hit the Earth, and then there'd be a big impact. But Mars is not going to go that. It's not going to leave the solar system, and it's not going to hit the Earth. It's in its own orbit, and the laws of physics will keep it in that orbit, essentially forever.
One question we have.
Dr.
Robert, sorry for delay. She asking you about, is that the best way to man to live on Mars? Is build a large greenhouse or large things, let's say buildings like that? Is that the best way?
Well, that is one very good way. When we first go to Mars, we will just live in our spacecraft. They will be our houses, and we will live inside of them. If we land a number of them, we could connect them and have more space to live. But once we're able, we would want to build large greenhouses on Mars, which could be domes, perhaps 100 meters in diameter, in which there would be living space and plants, and you could walk around. And we could also build much larger buildings that you could live inside of on Mars. But either on the surface, or we could create underground walls. Ultimately, people, when there's enough people on Mars with enough technology, we will start to transform Mars so that the whole planet will be habitable. But in the middle period, certainly we will live in large buildings and greenhouses on Mars.
Great. Doctor, we have another question from one of my friends. Said, sure, there is a difference between the atmosphere and weather of Mars and Earth. So what is the major points?
Please hold the microphone closer.
The major,
I can't hear it.
Oh, sorry.
If you don't.
The major differences between Mars and Earth weather. Sure, there is too much, but the major or the most important one. Is there clouds in the sky of Mars?
Check to make sure the microphone is on.
Can you hear me now, doctor?
Now it's better.
Okay. My friend asked you the differences between the atmosphere of Earth and Mars, and I'm adding this.
I can't hear you again.
Oh, just 1 minute, please.
Check the microphone. It might be off.
Okay, how now? It's okay? Doctor, are you hearing me? Dr. Phil?
Microphones like that sometimes have a switch.
Yes, it's on, but now?
Okay. I can't hear.
Just 1 moment, please. We tried to fix it. So, how about now?
A little better.
Okay.
Speak loud.
Okay. It's okay now?
Yes.
Okay. Sorry for that. They ask you about the difference between Mars and Earth weather. And I'm adding that for this question. Is there clouds in the skies of Mars?
You went off again.
Oh, sorry.
Very cloudy. The
time is cloudy. Dr. Robert, can you hear us now? Dr. Robert?
Sorry, I can't hear. But can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Yes, I can hear you.
What is that? But I can't
hear you.
I can see you, but I can't. Let me just say a final remark.
Okay.
If I may.
Okay.
Let me just make a final remark and you translate it for the students.
Okay.
Okay? Well, just two things. Number one, I think that science, invention, exploration are among the greatest things that people can do. I think people should do great things, and so I think that Kurds should do these things. That just in the process of creating a new and better world through science and invention.
I don't think so. You can hear us.
And one more thing, if I may.
Yeah.
A lot of Americans, I've urged, because the Kurds have been friends to America, and I also feel that way, but I have an additional reason to like the Kurds, which is this, is that the way I think of America is it's not just a country, it's a cause, and that cause is human freedom. And the enemies of human freedom say freedom is a curse. If people are made free, they will just destroy things. And that is sometimes true. But, you know, we Americans went into Iraq, we got rid of Saddam Hussein, and we said, now you are free, make of it what you will. And the people in the other parts of Iraq chose to use the opportunity to kill and destroy. But the Kurds showed that they could make freedom a blessing, not a curse. They showed that our cause is true. And I thank you for that.
Well, let's try again. I don't think so. If you can hear me, Dr. Robert, we are really honored. Thank you so much. I have to talking to you the language of science, so signing. So I have to say thank you very much. Really, really appreciate. We are really honored. And wabzanam sapechi bashkoliti. Thank you very much, Dr.
Thank you.
Thank you very
keep
much.
Going the way you're going.
Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much. It's a great honor.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. My students, my dear students, this is Mr. Dave, my very best friend. As you told about, I told you about him, he's the superman, he's the superstar of this event. So I really appreciate for what you do. And I'm sure you will enjoy with this event. So I'll let Dave talk, let him give him a chance to talk about himself for a little bit. I really appreciate that.
With events like this, what we aim to do is get you guys interested in science and engineering. And that way you guys can build a better future. I myself, I'm a professional engineer in the UK. I'm a former army medic for the British Army, and I've travelled the world. And I've seen what good people like yourself can do with science and engineering. I must admit, I'm actually utterly pleased to see the number of people that have came for today's event. It's breathtaking to see you guys here. It's been a long time for myself and Azzy organising this event. And it's just amazing for myself to see the number of people here. but what I want you guys to know is that with the science and engineering is a large community throughout the globe. It's something that you guys would be more than welcome to get involved with. There's many different fields in science and engineering that you guys can personally participate in. From astronomy to engineering, which is my favourite subject. And I'm sure Azzy has probably talked a fair bit about astronomy so far, and I hope you guys get involved with that.
Thank you very much, Dave. Dave, I have a question for you.
Yes, my friend.
Thank you very much. Also, all students here and dear teachers, also the director board here, after welcoming you, they really want to ask, why Kurdistan? What was the reason? What was the impact on you?
It's the people of Kurdistan. You guys are fairly well educated and you're ambitious. I want to welcome, and people who I work with want you guys to be a part of the science and engineering community. You guys have a lot to give to the world. And what you guys are going through at the moment, we all feel sympathetic to you. The troubles you face at the moment are the passing of ignorant minds. It'll be you guys who will come up better at the end. You will build a better world. And the reason that I picked this place was just that you guys inspire people like me. I mean, and I want you guys to know that the greater community in the world is inspired by you guys doing your best at the moment.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, my friend Dave. As we talking with you at our previous Skype calls, you mentioned about one important thing that probably we can do another project together here or outside Matir Fakhr Mirgasori educational compound.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It will be continued. And are you really like to joining us in the next future activities?
In a future activity, I will be across.
Great. Thank you very much. So about our friends, Phil and Robert. Guys here are asking about the questions. Some of them said probably this question will be primitive or simple. And I hear some really advanced questions. So one of them asking me a question, it's very fresh, 2014. I didn't hear about that. So probably this is a surprise because I didn't know about the case that one of the students talked about. So I'm sure it will be a fantastic event. I'm sure this will be a good victory for you. And I don't know what I say, Dave. I don't know really what I say.
This is my pleasure to see all of you people here. I am inspired by the number of people that have came up. It's fantastic. And I hope you guys enjoy today. And I hope you ask a lot of questions to Phil and Robert.
Tatwani, one of the students want to say thank you.
Hi, my name is Don and I'm 18. I want to thank you that you, we appreciate you that you gave your time to answer our questions and you take care of us as a country that fight against, you know that in our situation, we are fighting against ISIS and we are in a very abnormal situation here. And we, by the name of all of the students, we want to thank you very much. Thank you.
It's my honor.
Thank you. And as Kurdish people say, Zor Supas, thank you very much. Now I think the time is close to Dr. Philip. Excuse me. By the way, the study of them are not English. You know, we have schools in Erbil, especially all the program English, but here are all in Kurdish, but they can speak English well, and I'm sure they understand. As they understand you, I'm sure they're understanding Philip and Robert and enjoy and learn more about astronomy, my friend.
Don't worry if you're confused with the accent. I am Scottish, so we speak slightly different English.
I told them that Dave, he's from northern United Kingdom, as I'm right.
Yeah,
so the language there is the phonetic there is very different than the Britain or somebody in England. Dave, thank you very, very much.
Thank you. I'm fantastic times.
Thank you, and I'm sure you'll back up in us and you'll be online. Yeah. If in case anything happened, just set as an F-16 to bombard
the game. It will be fine. Enjoy yourself, guys.
Thank you very much, my friend. Thank you. We'll be honored. Thank you.
Take care.